Why do you think they prefer to
Because of the competition. I was teasing them a little bit, and I said it's also perhaps because of the taxpaying or something like that. But if tax authorities are everywhere, there is so much involved in that. So it's more because of competition. Because you are, as I said, you have to, you know, there are different actors around the world, and this is something fantastic what they have. So everybody is interested in it. And I think that the government should change the policy. I was in Slovenia, they gave them some money, you know. They gave them some money, they said these are centers of excellence. The government decided to make centers of excellence. And then they got the status of the center of excellence, and then they got, but you know, money that was like 50,000 euros, 100,000 euros, so it's not really big money. But still, you know, even 50,000 or 100,000 can be sometimes very important. And now our Minister of Economic Affairs, he helped this Hidria, who is a Chinese champion, to arrange to intervene in the bank. Because what did we do? I don't know how is the banking system here in this country. But we were having a lot of, our banks had a lot of bad loans. And so we had to give to Ljubljanska Banka, which is the biggest bank in Slovenia and in the past was the biggest bank in all Eastern Central Europe, and also the very successful bank. There was so much speculating and taking this bad loans from the United States, and then people selling packages of these bad loans, you know, to Western Europe, and then from Europe they bought it and so on. That Slovenia had to pay, Slovenian citizens had to pay 1.5 billion euros that this bank survived. And now this bank doesn't give the loans anymore. Now they give only to the one who is really very good, you know. So we have now healthy banks, but they don't give the loans. And we have a seed banker, which is the bank for development. So there you could get the loan with 2% of interest rate, and they were just for that established. And now we have even with this bank the loan. So I shall be talking tomorrow, after tomorrow, with the Prime Minister, and I shall certainly convince her that she has to throw out this guy. Because this is, you know, this is a state bank. This is a bank that is helping most innovative companies to develop. And it's called Development, Slovenian Development Bank. And then the guy was in Vienna, this is a huge champion, Istok Seljak, and he told me, he said, this is terrible how they don't understand. They were the number one innovative company in the whole Europe last year. So, you know, they just have a little problem because they have a loan. And this is perhaps 5 million, 6 million euros. It's not such a terrible amount of money, you know. It's not 1 billion and a half what we pay to the bank. So, I don't know, as I said, I'm too short time. I came yesterday and tomorrow I'm leaving. But I hope that I shall come regularly to your country because I really like to, you know, to follow the development and to see how it's going. And I think that we should also, like we did in SINA, we should more collaborate. You know, we should much more collaborate with Slovenia, Romania, and other countries here around, especially the new campus of the European Union, because together we are stronger. Because we could have our own interest. And I read somewhere that there are 30,000 lobbyists in the European Union. And this is really disgusting. 30,000 lobbyists, you know? How many are from Romania or Slovenia? I don't think that we have there anybody. So we should start to organize ourselves and collaborate with each other and do something together. I was now in Africa and I saw, and I was, you know, before in Latin America, and I saw how these countries don't cooperate neither. And I am proud that I helped establish CIMEC, because CIMEC is collaborative. You know, I came in October to, now I was in Colombia, but I was in October in Rio de Janeiro, where we had our seminar, and then I stayed there for the meeting of Latin American business, CLADEA, Latin American Association of 800 businesses. Some of them are really fantastic. And what did I see there? There was a conference of 3 days. The leader of the conference was a Brazilian who worked in the United States. The keynote speaker was the guy, professor, American president from Florida. Nothing really to be impressed by, but he was American. The president of the Association of Latin American Business Schools, because they change every 2 years, the actual one is Mexican who works in the United States. Before was a lady from Venezuela who works in the United States. I mean, this was here 20 years ago. And I was telling to my people, you know, Romanians and Russians and Polish and everybody, I went to, in fact, to America. I had a speech there and there were 1,700 teams. And I said, I come from Slovenia. Slovenia is in Central and Eastern Europe. And if you really, you don't have education like you had 100 years old management education, we don't have that. We just started. And if you really like to help us, give us the best from the West and keep the rest. You know? And this phrase was really helping. And everything else what we do, we started to communicate, to work together, to, you know, to be proud of ourselves. And this would not happen today in Eastern Central Europe, anywhere what I saw now in Latin America. And I was now in Kenya, where I was Association of 150 Deans of African Business Schools. Exactly the same, they said to me, help us, we should start to cooperate. We are only looking to the United States what we shall get. So you will not get, you know, first you will not get the number one quality because they can't share, because the good quality is a scarce resource. And why should one clinic that has one or two excellent doctors send these two doctors, you know, from Romania to Slovenia, if you have, they can't succeed even to make everything what they need to do here in Romania. So you are going and make a course for the surgeons and you are helping them, but you know, usually you are giving second and third grade class to other people because you are, this is a scarce resource for quality in every respect. So that's why, you know, we saw in many years ago, when the Berlin Wall was falling down, that we got a lot of interest and a lot of money was spent from the West, developed West, but we couldn't think of us at all what we need to get what we needed here. When I was advisor to the Romanian government many years ago, you know, that was, you can count, you know, soon after Ceausescu was gone, etc. What happened is that these guys, you know, they were next to me, sending somebody from Italy, or sending somebody from France, etc. And your guys from Romania were one of them. Said, first you need half a year to understand our country, so go and learn and then come back. They were right, you know. Because how can you come to help as a consultant to one country if you don't know anything about the country? So you have to be proud of yourself and show that you know what you want. And as I said, I was on one side, I was very sad to see in Africa because we were telling, 2 days I was explaining them what we did. I said, this is my personal story. And I told them. And you know what happened at the end? One of their main deans, the American was sitting next to me there, and he said to the American, can't you, we are making now one scientific newspaper magazine, can't you recognize it in the United States? So after 2 days of talking and convincing them how they have to make it by themselves, he said, can't you recognize? Why should an American recognize my magazine? I shall do my best to make it top. And then I'm, if already I want to show it to around, I shall show it to, you know, go to perform around the world and show it. And then I get the public from all over, not just, you know. So it's a difficult process in any case. But there we are. Any question for a shorter answer? access. We have one year, 2 years, and there's a 78. And we have all together in both in each class we have about 30 people. So we would like to report the because the crisis, you know, is also this crisis was the most effective mover than education. The youngest came, where they have education for youngsters, you know, 22, 23, there they have full classes because they don't have jobs, so they go to school. But where you have executive education, like we have, where you have to have minimum 3 years of work experience, there, you know, the companies, it's not the people in the past. It was like that. We had 70 and more percent of participants that were paid by companies and only some individuals. Now we have 70% of individuals who pay for their study and they can pay, you know, in different installments, etc. And about 30, this year is a little bit better, 30 who are, you know, paying the companies pay. So that percent changed. And the companies like very much in-company programs. They like very much that you come to them and you make it. Like you can go to Romania, make something or, you know. And they like seminars with inspiration. They need badly the seminars where you inspire people, where you affect them, where you make impact on them, where they go home and reach, where they go home and touched by something. That is what is very important. You know, we have still financial loan financial managers. This was our best ever. We made 200 of them. Still we have them. But this is the only one that we still have for performance or progress. For the rest, we have more like customer-centric organization, you know, leadership. We put them on the lake. We have half a day in the class on leadership and half a day on the lake, rowing and learning how to make a team, you know?
You don't have leadership at golf?
We have leadership at golf, Ian has leadership at art, you know, we have our garage, it's also painted, and we go in the garage, and we are painting, and doing all kinds of things. Ian, if you would like to mention something, you have, you're not that.
A little bit.
He was leading this case study competition, which we shall have next year again. And I would like to say that I really thank very much our alumnus, Christy and Stefan, who were helping to find the companies and doing that. That was good. And I hope that we shall, we have, you know, this club, we have 15 alumni clubs. We even established an open one in South Africa. 2-3 years ago, and the strongest and the best one, the most active one, was the Romanian alumni club, but it's not anymore. So the fact that I came here, I said I shall look deeply in the eyes of my alumni and ask them, why don't we make it again? Because alumni club is very important. Firstly, you know that you had so many Romanians leaving for Canada, that we were there helping them to organize themselves in a little club, and then many, and then I have 5-6 professors from Canada, and they were helping them to find a job there, mine and our professors, Canadians. So, you know, you can some, one of them is professor at our university, Randy Puder himself, etc. So, alumni clubs are to support each other and find, you know, good connections. But then it's also, we have every year Alumni Achievement Award, which is in October when we have President's Forum. And on that Alumni Achievement, and I really, there we have this famous lecture. So if you really would like to get this book on open innovation, as I said, I should send it to you, no problem. And that Alumni Achievement Award are people who did something special and they are proposed by their colleagues for the class. So, I would be happy to see one of Romania receiving the prize. Okay? I think it's time that I stop. There is something nice behind there to eat and to drink. And to drink, I still don't see. not people here. But still, on the table, now I need it. So thank you very, very much. And as I already said once today to the other groups who were competing, and I was very impressed by them, as I told you already, I would be very, very happy to receive you if you come to Slovenia or walk around there, you know, close to, this is 28 kilometers from the airport, even less now because we have auto roads, now too late, I'm almost too late. So I would be very, very happy and honored to have you there for a drink, for a coffee, tea, sugar, I can't walk the roads, but we have our own stuff. Yours yesterday, I tasted it after many years and it's absolutely strong, really strong. I shall not want to get it. So thank you very much for your kind attention. So if you take a moment to fill up, because that is really, thank you very much. That is really an opportunity that we learn something what we would like to get.